Well, we're going to hear this fabulous music. Where Diego's coming. Play this clip. Watch this.
Siento tu cuerpo vibrar cerca de mí. Es tu palpita, es tu cara, es tu pelo, son tus besos, me estremezco. Oh, oh.
All right, that is the music of Luis Miguel, but it is performed and sung, that it was your singing. Diego Bonetta is here. Nice to have you here today.
Thank you so much.
I do not know the Latin music world well, but I, like anyone, know Luis's name, which is as big as any name.
Yeah, I mean, it's very interesting because he is our Elvis Presley meets Frank Sinatra. That's kind of like the best way to describe mm-hmm. him. There's not a perfect example in the U.S. general market of what this man is, but what I can say is, you know, the one song he did in English was with Frank Sinatra before Frank passed away, and when they asked Frank, you know, what he thought about Luis Miguel, he said he was the best singer he'd ever heard.
Wow.
The guy has an unbelievable voice. I mean, similar register to Freddie Mercury, you know, very, very wow. high, potent voice, and he's been doing it for, I mean, almost four decades.
Telemundo Netflix airing a 12-part series about him, which you are the star of. You tell me, given the qualities that you just espoused, to take on the role and not have it dubbed, to really sing it.
Well, it was crazy because the last big project that I did was a movie called Rock of Ages based on the Broadway musical with Tom Cruise, and there was a lot of singing there as well. But I didn't have to sound like Steve Perry singing Don't Stop Believing. Here, it was, you have to sing Luis Miguel songs in the same key and everything, and you have to sound like him. But there's an element there which was experimental, which was changing the tone of voice, which is something that neither myself, the producer, or even my vocal coach had ever done. So we had a year to prep just on the transformation side of things. And I've never done a role that's been this challenging because I had to change from every single angle, the physical angle. I dropped, you know, 24 pounds, and then I had to do a gap in my teeth because he had a gap, and then the vocal angle, which was very challenging, and then also the acting side of things, given the fact that, you know, this is a man that no one knows anything about him.
Right.
You know, he's been very, very private and closed when it comes to his private life. He had a very troubling childhood, similar to Michael Jackson in many ways, with his dad being a very strong figure. And this is the first time ever he's coming clean. There's been no documentaries, no biographies. This is the first time this is authorized by him.
So what I envision in my own head is just like that brief thing that we saw in the limo. And that was his whole life, that there's, you know, just this parade of amazing women.
Did you see Ray or Walk the Line?
Sure, yes, both.
It's kind of in that world.
Okay.
So you see, you know, that human side of almost like a mythological saint,
right.
or like a godlike kind of guy. Seeing his relationship with his girlfriends, with his father, and seeing that side that no one has ever seen before in a very raw, very tasteful. It's very well done, but it's also very edgy.
And then there's this whole notion of general audiences and this audience of one.
Yeah.
So he authorized it. He approved it.
Yeah.
Were you doing it for him, or were you doing it for the public at large?
I think I was doing it for both. I got to play my hero, which is, I think, something that it doesn't normally happen. You know, the first song that I ever sang when I was 12 years old, it happened to be one of his songs. That was 16 years ago. And the first newspaper article that came out about me was comparing me to him. I didn't know 16 years later I was gonna be playing him. So that was a pretty cool, it was cool how it came back full circle. I did it for him, but also for the audience, and I'm really proud of this project because, you know, you hear of all these Latin projects, and a lot of them are narco based,
sure.
right? And this is not that. This is a success story of our Frank Sinatra, someone that is internationally known, maybe not in the U.S. general market, but in the U.S. Latin market and other countries.
Oh, my gosh.
He's huge.
Right.
When you say you had to change your vocal tone and everything, like when they say all of a sudden to an actor, you're going to be playing the part of a boxer, all of a sudden they're in the gym 20 hours a day and they're doing that. How many hours did you spend with a vocal coach and what were the exercises?
I mean, it was literally a year of just prep, which that doesn't happen. You know, normally, you know, the most I've had on movies is maybe 3-4 months. So I had to divide my day up to go to my vocal coach, who was the same vocal coach that helped me or helped all the actors in Rock of Ages. His name is Ron Anderson, and go, Ron, what do we do here?
Help me.
And it was going really, really going for the smallest of details, going from, okay, well, let's change your vibrato to the way his vibrato sounds. Now let's focus on the vowels and how he pronounces the A's and the E's, and now let's go to the consonants. It was, I'm not sure if you're a big Formula One or NASCAR fan, but it was almost like asking, you know, a pilot, you know, or a car racer, you know, we want you to do this circuit in the exact same time X other person did it, taking the same turns and the same angle, but do 12 circuits, not one, because it was 12 songs. Right. And each song is different, and each song has its own thing, right? And that was very challenging. But also a very challenging side of things was, you know, how do you play someone who's kind of a ghost, right? Because you have all these references of him in interviews and stuff, but the personal side, no one knows him personally. Yeah. I mean, you know more about Leo DiCaprio than this man, right? So it was spending time with him and being very respectful, you know, because like I said, a lot of this is very, very tough on him. You know, he had a really, really tough childhood, and you always want to be respectful when it comes to that. And my job here was to humanize this legend. It was amazing, and I'm really proud of it.
We should tell people that the Luis Miguel, the series premieres Sunday, April 22nd at 9 p.m. on Telemundo. Diego, when you come back, we'll talk Terminator, some other things. Good to see you this morning. Thank you. Thanks so much.
So fascinating. Thank you. Good.